Double inlet left ventricle, or double inlet ventricle, is a condition in which the blood flow from the body and the lungs comes back to a common atrium and then drains into a single ventricle through two separate valves, or AV valves. In the circulation, all of the blood flow mixes in that single ventricle, and that mixed blood gets pumped out to both the lungs and the body. However, patients with this type of circulation have cyanosis, or low oxygen levels, and under normal conditions will be able to tolerate this for a period of time. Ultimately, these patients typically undergo a Fontan procedure. However, we've devised a new operation to help patients with double inlet ventricle to undergo a biventricular repair or a 1.5 ventricle repair, thereby avoiding the Fontan procedure, and I want to explain how this is done. In the first stage, a pulmonary artery band is placed in order to stabilize the circulation so that a child can get out of the neonatal time frame. In some situations, we may have to do what's called a Norwood procedure, in which we connect up the blood vessels exiting the right ventricle and the left ventricle to create a single outflow. Once the neonatal palliative procedure is done and the circulation is stabilized, we come back at somewhere around 4 to 6 months of age to perform the second stage procedure. In the second stage procedure, a bidirectional Glenn can be performed, in which the blood flow coming back from the upper body is redirected into the lungs. But at the same time, we try to place a patch inside the ventricle, dividing it into two separate ventricles that will ultimately be used to pump to separate circulations. In this septation, we create a patch that goes between the two inflow valves, thereby separating the inflow into an inflow that will go to the lungs and an inflow that will go to the body. We match the inflows with the outflows so that all of the blood flow coming back from the body gets pumped out into the lungs, and all of the blood flow coming back from the lungs gets pumped to the body. But we don't complete the septation all at once in the second stage procedure. And the reason is because we don't want the heart to have to tolerate a complete biventricular repair all at once. So we leave a few holes in the patch so that blood can go back and forth between the two ventricles. This allows some decompression of each ventricle. Now, in this new circulation, blood flow streams favorably. That means that the blue blood goes to the lungs and the pink blood goes to the body. Even though there's a single ventricle, this single ventricle has now been separated into two functionally different chambers. As a child grows, the patches stay the same size, and so the new ventricles remodel and form essentially two separate ventricles. At the third stage operation, we can then separate these two ventricles into two separate circulations so that the blood flow coming back from the body goes in through the right ventricle and out to the lungs, whereas the blood flow coming back from the lungs goes into the new left ventricle and out to the body. This is a more normal circulation, and this procedure allows for normalization of oxygen saturations. This allows us to avoid some of the complications that can be associated with the Fontan procedure. In some patients, we will leave the bidirectional Glenn in place to help unload the smaller of the two ventricles. But eventually, we may be able to take down the bidirectional Glenn and normalize the circulation, thereby creating a biventricular circulation. We feel that this circulation is better than the Fontan because it allows the oxygen levels to normalize without increasing the pressure on the liver and the lower body organs like the Fontan does.